Before introducing myself, I want to start with a quote of one of the smartest men to ever live that says that it is not the strongest of species that survive, and nor the most intelligent, but rather the one that's most responsive to change. And this is, of course, a quote of Dan Abramov, and this is a technical talk told in a story way, and this is the story about myself and my team at Ilmex and our decision to, well, survive. So my name is Ariel. I'm based in Tel Aviv. I'm a full stack developer working for Ilmex, an amazing company. I'm really obsessed with Next.js, React, TypeScript, and my dog. My dog is really obsessed with clean code. And let's start telling the story. So this all starts 5 months ago, right around the time where Next announced the app router going into stable mode. At that point, I was getting really hyped and I was really starting to seriously consider to migrate to Next. So I went up to my boss and I told him that I think we need to migrate. And he looked at me pretty much like that. And he was mumbling stuff about you front-end developers and your trends and your daily framework. Understanding where he is coming from, I told him to check out the showcase of the companies that have already done this migration. And looking at the showcase, we're not really hipsters here. And he got back to me and he told me, you know what, if you really believe in this, so you have a couple of days, put together a slideshow. And if you manage to convince the team, it's yours. So this following preview has been brought up to you by my boss that made me put this slideshow together. And this is our story at Ilmex. And these are basically the slides that I use to convince my team. So when we're talking about migrations, we want to always start by asking, what is wrong now? Why do we even need to change anything? And the problems that we were facing were not problems that are Ilmex specific. Those were problems that are SPA related, and any client-side rendered applications would encounter these problems. And the problems are as such that performance isn't great. SEO is basically impossible. We have a lot of client code to maintain. Builds are slow. And basically the client is doing some really heavy lifting. And if we look at the left side of this of these problems, we can see that these are user-related problems, user experience related. And if we look at the right-hand side of this, we can say that these are developer experience related problems. And both of these intersect on the client doing some really heavy lifting. The client is in charge of routing, fetching data from the server, storing it in the state, storing when it is waiting for data, storing when the data is wrong. By this point, we have so much code and stuff to manage that we can't avoid optimization, state management, memoizations, cachings. And of course, by this point, we have so much code that we can't avoid some Webpack dark magic. So chunking and tree shaking and whatnot. And by this point, a guy in my team asked a good question and said, but isn't it a good thing that the client is doing all of these things? And I was like, thanks, Tim, because that was the perfect intro for my next bit, which is a short movie that I prepared for you about a guy named Tom and his bicycle. So 10 years ago, a boy named Tom wanted a bicycle, but the mechanic lived on the other part of the river. And when he asked her for a bicycle, she built him a bicycle. He was happy. But Tom was a human being, so pretty fast he got bored of his bicycle and wanted a car. And he went back to the mechanic and asked for a car. By that point, she was hesitant because this rope bridge can't really carry a car. But then she had an idea. What if instead of bringing him a car, she can bring him the parts of the car and Tom can build the car himself? Tom thought about it and realized that it's better than not having a car. So he agreed. The mechanic gave Tom the parts. Tom became Tom the builder. He built his own car and he was happy. But he was still a human being. So he thought, why should I stop with the car now that I can build anything that I want? So he started building stuff that he was less and less capable of building. It wasn't an easy task, but he preferred to have mediocre vehicles than none at all. And the years went by, the rope bridge is gone. There is a real road now, but human habits don't change. And Tom is still getting his cars and parts. And Tom's story, that's our story. It's the SPA story. 10 years ago, network wasn't amazing. We had inconsistency in JavaScript version between the different browsers. And the only way for us to give our users a decent experience was to turn their browsers into builders. However, things are not the same. The infrastructure change, network, 5G, all browsers in the green zone, even Node.js supporting native ES modules. And we don't really need to be bringing cars and parts anymore. And meta frameworks step in and say, guys, we can just bring them cars. And what we are doing beyond telling our client, you want a car, go build it, we are actually doing something that is even far worse than that. And let me explain. When I'm talking about cars, I'm talking about pages, that each page is using different components, some of them are shared. And you might be thinking, why is a car a page? Why isn't a car an application? And the answer for that is that this is our browser. Their browser looks like this, not like this, not like this. Our browser doesn't have a time turner. Our browser only looks like this, which means there's only one URL. So at any given point in time, the client would always only need one part of the application, one page at a time. And what do? We wrap it all up together into one component and we tell him that if he wants a car, not only needs to go and build that car, he needs to go and build all of the cars. And well, we don't need to do this anymore. We can just give them a car and tell them to put petrol. And let me explain what do I mean by petrol. In the SPA approach, you would have a CDN that's serving an index HTML to your client. And by the way, when they say single page application, this index HTML is the single page we are talking about. And in this index HTML, we would have two things. First one is a big bundle of JavaScript. Second one would be a very empty HTML. And these two together are the car parts with which the client would build the UI. And Next.js has a completely different approach. So you would have a server with a Node.js process. And between this server and the client, you would have CDNs that are spread all over the world. And using React server components already on the server, and that's why it's important to state that this is a Node process because we are running JavaScript on the server here. So with Node, we would create the DOM already on the server. Using React server components, we can turn React components into HTML already on the server, which allows us to give the DOM already pre-built per each route. And the only thing the client would have to do is to put some petrol. That is, in other words, rehydration. Elements that are interactive, that are dependent on event listeners in the browser, only these elements in the DOM would be re-rendered by the client. And by this point, of course, again, my team intervened again and said that this is cool, we understand the motivation, but this is a lot of effort. And he wasn't wrong, but I was saving my strongest arguments to be last. And my strongest arguments are these. React official documentation recommend using a framework when you're building an application with React. React core team members saying that if you're not using a framework, you need to incrementally migrate to one. So there's a reason why the first slide here was about survival. This is not about being cutting edge. This is not even about SSR. This is about understanding where the industry is heading and us not wanting to be deprecated in X amount of time. And by this point, my team got convinced and they were like, okay, what's the plan? So the plan was to stop all feature development and migrate our components to server components. I hope nobody believed that. I don't know how your paying customers get with infrastructure refactors, but we knew that we needed a real plan. And in the real plan, we can't stop feature development. We need to keep delivering. And the magic word here is an incremental migration. So we have this massive tree, right? And it's changing constantly when we are developing features. And this is like a really interesting problem. Like, how do you even refactor a tree that's constantly moving? And the answer is that you don't. The solution that we came up to this in order to maintain an incremental migration is as such. At the moment, we are giving them all the parts for all the cars at the moment. And we said, okay, why don't we just make it a bit better at a time? So just for the first phase, we would give them smaller client-side rendered application. So they would still be building cars, but they would build them one at a time. So instead of having to refactor this whole massive tree, now we would be dealing with a few smaller trees, which make it a lot easier to work in an incremental way and to slowly coalesce server components. And in a long story short, our client application used to be, well, an application, and it ended up as a package, which we slowly took down to smaller parts. And If somebody wants to hear more about how did we achieve this in more than 10 minutes, I would love for you to approach me on LinkedIn, on email.